Derek?
What do you want?
Actually, I'm trying to talk to Mugatu, but he's tougher to get to than the president.
Oh, thought you were going to tell me what a bad Yagoogalizer I am.
A what?
A Yagoogalizer? One who speaks at funerals? Or did you think I'd be too stupid to know what a Yagoogly was?
The Don and Mike Show.
But I know how that guy felt. Man, oh, Shevitz. I'll miss you guys. I miss you all very much. I don't think he loves football as much as I love radio. I don't think that's the case. I remember, hey, it's the Don and Mike Show, last show ever, last 10 minutes here. Appreciate you listening. Just me, Don. Everybody else is split. I remember sitting in a car in a radio station parking lot with a guy listening to Larry Lujack do his last show in WCFL change formats. I would stay up all night going to Denny's with my friends, talking about what we were going to achieve in the radio business and the dragons that we were going to slay. And here we are 35 years later, and there's not a lot of us left from that era. I've worked with so many great guys, and I've been sitting here just realizing all of the names that I'm forgetting. Howard Hoffman, great, great friend. Dave Fox, best man at my wedding. Lou Katz, a lifelong friend. Wally Dempsey. All of these guys were guys that I've known and loved my whole life. All of them involved in radio, and for that, I thank them. I've got some limited time here. I'm going to play two songs because sometimes they're easier than actually talking. The first one is going to be from my family. From my son, my daughter, my mom, Big Frida, and the gal who I'm going to marry next summer, Janet. Because this all ends on Monday. And come Monday, I will be your normal guy.
Heading up to San Francisco for the Labor Day weekend show. I got my hush puppies on. I guess I never was meant for glitter rock and roll. And honey, I didn't know that I'd be missing you so. Come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in the brown early haze, and I just want you back by my side. Yes, it's been quite a summer. Rent a cars and westbound trains. And now you're off on vacation, something you tried to explain. And darling, it's I love you so. That's the reason I just let you go. Come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side. I can't help it, honey, you're that much a part of me now. Remember that night in Montana when we said there'd be no room for doubt. I know that it's pretty up there. We can go hiking on Tuesday. With you I'd walk anywhere. California has worn me quite thin. I just can't wait to see you again. Come it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side. I spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side.
That's hi. Hi. That's for Frida too. But that's mainly for my family. Because when Monday comes, I won't be thinking about this show, which will be hard. We've been off the air about a month. I've had a lot of time to think about what I'd like to say. I can't believe that I'm actually leaving of my own accord. I love doing this so much. I think I've tried to articulate today why I'm leaving now. To you people who listened all of these years, I have never properly thanked you for your support. Mike and I have come on over the years and bragged about our ratings and our contracts and how great our lives are. And I've often said to people, this is not like sports where you pay the salaries, so shut up. But the truth is, that was just me being the hypocrite that I am. It is about you guys. Because if you don't listen, I don't care if you're the nicest guy in the world, the meanest guy in the world, the least talented or the most talented. In this biz, there's one axiom that's been true since day one. Three R's: ratings, revenue, rock and roll. You gotta have the ratings and you gotta have the revenue, and that makes the rock and roll. And it does not happen without you. Every day, you punched in. And I appreciate it. No, Mike does and everybody else does. This is my last chance for a while to be on the radio. So I want to tell you, I more than appreciate it. I love you for it. I can't think of too many things in my life that I feel about the way that I know a lot of people feel about this show. And I dig that about you guys. I know what it's like on the days when we weren't here, when you didn't know where we were, and no one would tell you anything, and you'd feel angry or betrayed. Well, kids, that's how big time radio is. I mean, to do a radio show, it used to be you needed a microphone and a box of records. Now you need a microphone and two lawyers. Biz has changed, but the one thing that has not changed is that if you can make a connection with people, you, the broadcaster, shall be rewarded.